Hello guys and welcome back to another episode of Game of Thrones. We left here with this character that we are playing now. The name of her is Mira, as far as I know.
I wonder if it's
she looks really nice. A beautiful woman. And I don't know if this is a daughter too of the Lord Forrester that died.
A gift from Roderick.
It could be, I mean, I would guess, yes.
I hope to see them all someday.
They seem to be all in our in one family, but I don't know. I think the first character that we played is only a cousin. It's not the son of the Forrester Lord. So maybe
Ethan made this for me.
That was the cousin of Ethan and Mira, and then I think the Lord Forrester has four childs or kids, however you wanna call it, call them. So I don't know what we have to do here, honestly. I think we have to escape or something like that, but I don't know if we can go outside. Nope. Doesn't look like it. Here? Is here something? No. Is here something else that we can interact with? As I told you, the graphics are not really the best one. And look at this here. It's not really accurate. Oh, there's a letter from her mother. I think we have to read this letter.
It troubles me to even ask this of you, but you must appeal to Lady Marjorie to intervene on our behalf. She is our best hope, and can be a powerful ally, especially now when your family so desperately needs her help.
Okay, so that was that. Oh, there's someone knocking on the door. Okay, let's
One
see.
Moment.
Who is it?
Oh, sorry, m'lady. I didn't mean to disturb you. I can come back later if you'd like.
Looks like a servant, I think. Let him in.
No,
I don't know.
Come in.
Who is this guy? Let him in, I mean. Ah, yeah. He does something here in the room. It seems, I think he cleans up or something.
Begging your pardon, lady, but
oh, he's putting coal in the
if you don't mind my asking, you seem
razor. You seem right, I'm fine. I'm fine.
I'm fine, thank you.
Of course, m'lady.
Please hurry if you can. Lady Marjorie will be here any minute.
Of course, m'lady.
Hmm.
You work for Lady Marjorie? I may be wrong, but it seems like you do.
I'm her handmaiden.
That's what I thought. I've seen you with her before. You seem like good friends. I saw Lady Marjorie just this morning, outside the royal sept, talking to Queen Cersei.
Cersei?
They appeared to be having some sort of disagreement. I couldn't hear much, but it was definitely an argument.
What did they say?
I couldn't make out much, but I know they were talking about the
Starks. Let's ask what did they say,
House
better.
Forrester.
House Forrester?
Eh?
I hope you're not in any kind of trouble. But I thought you ought to know. Most people don't tend to notice a coal boy. Not in King's Landing, with so many lords and ladies about.
So he's a coal boy. So he does only this?
People don't even know you're there.
That's why he's a little bit black on the... Well,
good night, my lady.
Let's say, not clean. I mean, he has this black, parts on his arms. Oh.
Lady Marjorie.
Is this this is Lady Marjorie.
I was hoping there would be time for us to talk.
Looks not bad.
Come. There's something we must discuss.
I mean, until this point all the women's looked really nice. Well, beautiful, let's say. You see it.
From the day you arrived in Highgarden, I've thought of you more as a friend than as my handmaiden. A dear friend, in fact.
Thank you, my lady.
And you know how I feel about what's happened to your family. I feel your pain as if it were my own. What you've suffered is beyond imagining. And your poor family as well.
I need your help, my lady.
Of course. And I will help you in any way I can. But there's another matter we must attend to first. You must understand there are limits to what I can say, especially here in King's Landing, now that I am to be queen.
Okay.
To have a handmaiden from the north, whose family fought for Robb Stark. It raises questions at a time I can least afford. Cersei herself cornered me this morning outside the Royal Sept. She mentioned the northern girl in my service, and she painted you a traitor. She was very pleased with herself. Her face was full of mirth as she said it.
How did you respond?
I told her you are one of my most trusted handmaidens, that you can hardly be blamed for the actions of your father and brother. Nonetheless, she demands an audience. She wants an apology of some sort, for what I don't know, but she's waiting for us now, and I promised I would bring you to her. I wouldn't ask this of you if it were not important. I cannot afford any conflict with Cersei with the wedding so near.
What do I
say? Cersei, who is this? And she's the queen, and who is Cersei? And the queen should be a little bit more higher on the rank, and I don't think there's someone. Queen Regent. So it's another queen.
You'll be fine. I know you will. You may feel one thing, but you must say another.
Good luck.
Okay, so I have to answer nicely or what? I mean, let's see what she got to say or what's the matter of this invitation. Okay, we have.
You can do this.
We have to walk to her, or yeah, we have to. We're walking really slow. Oh, okay.
Ah, Lady Marjorie, aren't you looking lovely this evening?
Lord Tyrion, Your Grace.
So this little man is a lord.
With your permission. Allow me to introduce Lady Mira of House Forrester.
Stand tall, bow your head. Let's say bow your head.
Your Grace.
Yet not honored enough to kneel, I see.
House Forrester is a northern house loyal to the king.
Are they?
I beg your pardon, Your Grace.
I wasn't talking to you. I want to hear from the girl. Is your family loyal to the king?
Perhaps you should ask the new Lord Forrester.
He's not here, is he? She is.
Joffrey is the one true king, Your Grace.
And yet, for centuries the Forresters have been loyal bannermen to House Stark, a house of traitors.
They were the Wardens of the North. We all served at the pleasure of the king.
Clever girl.
I
too clever for her own good.
Chose the random blue. Your answer did not satisfy her.
Is your house willing to swear fealty to your new liege lord, Roose Bolton?
Yes, Your Grace. Absolutely.
I see. despite the fact Roose Bolton allied with Walder Frey. If it was me, I'd find it difficult to so quickly forgive the men who killed my father. Old allegiances are not easily abandoned. But now that the war is over, we must look to rebuild and forge new alliances. There are ships and shields to be built, and Joffrey will need a steady supply of ironwood for his armies. I'm told there are others who would happily serve that purpose, but I trust we can rely on House Forrester.
Forrester Ironwood does seem rather unique.
What? Sorry, guys.
It's not them. It would be a shame to see it.
I was looking something.
I imagine you'd do almost anything to prevent that from happening, wouldn't you? Ask any Lannister, and they'd do whatever was necessary to save Casterly Rock. It would be unfortunate to see another house lay claim to what's yours.
I won't dishonor myself, Your Grace.
I see.
What would you have the girl do, Cersei? It's not as if she fought beside the Starks, wielding a battle axe for the Northern Army.
It raises an interesting question, I suppose. Can we truly blame those who end up on the wrong side of the war? Our dear Margaery here was betrothed to Rhaenyra Baratheon on the false assumption that he would one day rule the Seven Kingdoms. Can we fault her for her mistake? Should she be held accountable?
I'm sure she regrets it.
Perhaps not.
If there's a point to this, I hope you find it quickly.
Loyalty can be such a hard thing to define. This city alone is filled with all sorts of ambitious opportunists looking to reinvent themselves, pretending to be something they're not. Who knows what lurks within their hearts? You are a girl from the North, here in service to Lady Margaery. One can only assume her interests are yours. Yet loyalty to a king, that must be absolute, beyond question. And if your loyalties were to become conflicted between your king and the very person whom you serve, what would you do then?
I'm sure she would...
Let the girl answer the question.
Go on.
I must choose Margaery, Your Grace. I serve at her pleasure.
Clearly your handmaiden does not have her priorities straight.
She is a threat to the crown, isn't she? The most dangerous handmaiden in all of King's Landing.
Really?
I'm not quite sure what to make of her. Not surprising, I suppose, for a northern girl. But not very encouraging either. I'd like a word with you, if I may.
Of course, Your Grace.
I wonder what they mean with Northern girl. From Scotland or what? And they are from England? I don't really know.
I'll walk you out. This may come as a surprise, but I met your father once, at the tourney at Lannisport. Even then he didn't trust Roose Bolton. We only spoke briefly, but your father struck me as an honorable man. You have my condolences for his loss. These would be trying times for your family, even under the best of circumstances.
Thank you, Lord Tyrion. That's very kind of you to say.
You were brave.
Well, he seems kinder than I thought. Maybe he's just playing with us, but...
She will not soon forget what you said. It was quite the first impression. I, of course, found it all highly entertaining. But it certainly wasn't what Cersei was expecting.
I wasn't trying to please her.
I think that was clear to everyone. My sister and I have our...
Oh, okay, she's the sister, okay. I thought they were together, but I wondered why the throne in the middle is empty, because I guess the king is sitting in the middle, so yeah. They are both not the kings or queens or however, they're only the... There is no really king, I think.
I speak for the crown in this regard, not her.
What are you suggesting?
Let's see what he got to say.
Could be persuaded to secure Ironwood from House Forrester. Lady Margaery might not look favorably on such an alliance, and it would infuriate Cersei. Although what would be amusing for me might prove rather dangerous for you and your house. Are you willing to risk that? It may be far too dangerous. In fact, forget I even suggested such a thing.
I'm sorry, Lord Tyrion. But it's a risk I cannot afford.
I don't know what he really means, but let's say this. Let's go, sure.
Now, if you'll excuse me, I promised Sansa I would join her for dinner tonight. Three beautiful bottles of Dornish wine await my arrival. The mere thought of them makes me thirsty already.
Thank you for the advice, Lord Tyrion.
Just be careful. This is not the North. King's Landing can be a nest of vipers to the uninitiated.
Okay.
Mira, I was worried. How was it? Cersei has a way of looking at you as though you're nothing.
It didn't go very well.
I'm sorry. Cersei is known for being rather difficult.
Who is this girl, I wonder? Oh, woman.
Lady Margaery has spent the entire day working on seating arrangements for the wedding. Of course, you and I are seated way at the back. Here with the fourth cousins and the ninth-born sons. Sir Jaime. I wouldn't mind tarnishing that white cloak of his.
Sarah!
What? It's true. And Oberyn Martell, the Red Viper. I'm told he has a paramour. Which I doubt is Dornish for wife.
He is quite handsome.
Let's say this, I don't even know who it is. But let's just say this.
Perhaps Lady Margaery can make the right introductions. Who knows? We might meet our future husbands. Although, marrying a king, I can only imagine what that would be like. Would you marry Joffrey if it meant you'd become queen? He does have a certain look about him, and he's always treated Lady Margaery well. Which is more than
not to Joffrey.
I'd be willing to marry, but not Joffrey.
Well, I would marry him. Imagine the power you would have as Queen of the Seven.
Yeah, you would marry anyone, it seems. Especially King.
Who else should we marry off? Brienne of Tarth and Tyrion Lannister. What a perfect match! Sir Bronn and...
What are you doing? Well? Sarah?
I'm sorry, my lady.
As am I. We shouldn't have been messing about.
This is not a game. It's a battle plan. Allies and enemies can be made with every move. Yet they say it is men who are powerful. The Queen was rather disappointed by your display, Mira. I'm just glad it's over. King's Landing can be exhausting sometimes. There's always someone to please.
Okay, so she's the queen. Okay. I thought she's a princess only.
Get worse when I am queen.
But okay.
True heart, the lords and ladies will have no choice but to love you.
Do you agree?
People are not always so easy to please. If you showed Cersei your true heart, she would stab it with a fork.
You learn very quickly.
Yeah, that's true, I think.
You were brave agreeing to obey the Boltons. That cannot have been easy. I know you must fear what Lord Bolton might do to your family. I do appreciate your willingness to appease her, as difficult as it may have been.
Thank you, my lady. There's been something on my mind. Something important.
Yeah, let's see, ask for help.
I did have a favor to ask of you in return.
Whatever you wish to say, you can say it in front of Sarah. There are no secrets between us.
It's about my family.
I trust her.
I don't trust her.
I prefer to speak with you alone.
Yep. I think you'll never know, so...
Go on. Ask.
Forgive me, my lady. I wouldn't otherwise ask this of you, but my mother insisted. It's about my family.
Ramsay Snow. What would you have me do?
My mother fears our family will suffer if Ramsay is left to do as he likes. She thought, if a raven could be sent to the Boltons to let them know House Forrester has the protection of the crown. I know it's a lot to ask of you, and I wouldn't otherwise, but she insisted.
That is no small request, especially now.
I know, my lady, and I wouldn't ask this of you otherwise. But my mother has left me no choice. She insisted.
Joffrey knows only too well your family fought for the Starks, and now you would have me ask him to intervene. Is the situation that dire? Joffrey will not look favorably on such a request.
It is that dire, my lady. I fear for my family's safety.
I mean, they... The guy said he will tell the king and let us attack, so I think it's really... if he is certain you are adored by the king, let's say this.
Don't let the queen bully you. You have power over him, Lady Marjorie, as no one else does. Not even his mother. Ramsay Snow will arrive at Ironwrath within the week. I would never ask this of you if it weren't so urgent.
Very well. I'll make your request, but I cannot promise anything.
Thank you, my lady. I will send a raven to my family at once.
A raven? It's a little bit odd, or not, to use a raven to submit messages or letters. Normally they used these other birds. But yeah. Apparently here they use ravens. Well trained ravens. So it seems that we are playing with this guy again. I forgot the name of him. And it seems they are torturing someone.
Did you know my ancestors wore the skins of their enemies as a coat?
Did he saw us? So what, we have to look?
Not my best work, unfortunately.
What the?
I suppose I have fallen out of practice. But he didn't make it easy, what with all that bloody noise.
Like a drowning cat.
You have to pay attention that they don't see us, I think.
As my father likes to say, a naked man holds few secrets, but the flayed man holds none.
Pity he didn't know your
I think when it gets full red or something, then they will see us.
Now.
Can we stay like this and they don't see
How much
us?
Further is it to these
okay, it's
foresters.
Already gone.
A day, my lord. Two at most.
What was that?
My lord?
Shh! Listen!
So guys, at this point we'll take a break. This point of the game seems a good spot. So I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you guys in the next episode of Game of Thrones.